I'm Jack.
And I'm Bronson.
And welcome to Baron News. Bronson, how have you been?
Tired. It's been a long week.
Yeah.
Busy.
Yeah. Busy. Well, let's get into the news. Today's the last day that the juniors will be testing. They have their science and U.S. history test. How did you do on that, by the way?
I think I did good on history, not good on science. That's a lot of graphs, dude.
Yeah.
That sucked. Oh, the NHS band has their OSSAA state contest today at OU. Sticking with the news about the band, they have some concerts coming up. The NHS Jazz Band concert is April 25th. The Middle School Band Awards concert is the 27th. And the NHS Band concert is May 8th. They are all at 7 p.m. in the Den.
The Noble Band is presenting the Addams Family Musical. The show times from it will be April 13th through the 16th, but on the 13th through 15th, it's at 7:30. And on the 16th, it is at 2 p.m. All of this will be in the Den.
Well, I think we have a little video about the story about that.
Let's play it.
I'm Tristan Adams with Bear News. Recently, we took a look inside the production of our theater department's latest musical, The Addams Family. What we saw was a great cast of actors who fit the parts well and a musical director who's truly dedicated to the show and wants to make sure everything turns out perfect. We interviewed their director, Frau Will, who is also the high school German and choir teacher, to get a better understanding of what it takes to produce a musical and the challenges needed to overcome. Here's what she had to say about that.
The hardest part, I think, was the music, just because there's so much of it. And for my ensemble, I would say the dances are probably the most difficult part, but they've really come into their own on it, and so is the whole cast, so yeah.
It takes a lot of effort to put a show together. While Frau Will is the director, she's not alone in producing this. It helps tremendously to have a dedicated cast and crew who are putting forth their best effort to make sure everything is running smoothly. One cast member, Aurora, had this to say about the production.
I would say that one of the biggest obstacles would definitely be we have had some technical issues. Right when we were about to start designing the lighting board shorted out and we weren't able to get a replacement. So we actually just yesterday got a rented one, and we thought for a while that we were gonna have to postpone the show. Another big thing is there's just not a lot of interest in the arts a lot of the time. And so we have a really, really small ensemble and they work really hard. So I'm grateful to have them, but it's definitely less than we were expecting.
When watching some form of content, whether it's a TV show, a movie, or in this case, a musical, everyone is going to be drawn to some aspect of whatever it is they're watching. It could be a character, it could be a scene, or even the way the show presents itself. When I say everyone, I mean everyone, including the director.
My first favorite aspect is my favorite character. My favorite character is Morticia, because she's hilarious. She has some really great songs, and just her overall vibe throughout the show is really funny.
While Morticia is a good pick, I would say my personal favorite character is Uncle Fester, because I think he looks silly. Some of you may be wanting to attend the show, but wants to know what the price is. Well, I'm here to answer that question for you. For adults, the price is $10, and for students, $5. Do you have children that are 3 years or old or younger? Well, I got some news for you, because children 3 and under can get in free. After talking to the producer and a cast member and getting a really good idea of what it's like to produce a musical and how much effort it takes, I would say it's well worth a watch. The musical is set to premiere on April 13th, going to the April 16th. However, due to an issue with the lighting system, there is a good chance for the musical to be postponed. It would be weird to watch a musical without proper lighting. With that in mind, I'm Tristan Adams, signing off.
Wow. Congratulations to Talon and Tristan for that video. It was very good. And now it's time for a message from the FCA. On April 29th, the OU Stadium, there will be a massive worship with Chance the Rapper as a headline. It's totally free, but you have to get your tickets at fts-23.com. Doors open at 5, but the concert starts at 7.
There's going to be a blood drive on April 19th from 8:30 a.m. to 2 p.m. It's going to be in the Old Noble Gym. Please sign up at the main office or visit redcrossblood.org/rapidpass. Oh.
IDs are required for that. Are you gonna give blood?
I don't know.
I am. You should always donate blood if you can.
Yeah.
Class selection forms are still in the office for pickup, but you can get them before the 19th. That'll be for the 2023-2024 school year.
I mean, we had a lot today. Next, the driver's ed course of the year is now open for enrollment. It'll be from begin the week of January, July 10th, and you can find information forms in the office, or you can go to the NHS website. Only the first 24 people to sign up will get a spot, so hurry up.
There is a lot of stuff today. This is the last week to buy your prom tickets. They are now $50. Go see Miss Daly or Miss Swope to buy them. And if you made a deposit for your tickets in January or February, those need to be paid in full by Thursday. I bought my prom tickets literally before we started filming today.
I bought them like a month ago. You're slow. Yeah. And finally, here's a video from the Smash team. Sucks.
Dude, Noble Smash Summit, more like Noble Trash Summit, am I right? Alright, we're done. Oh, we're done.